Forever could never be long enough for me. I feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do. I bet the weight has lifted. Love has surely shifted my way.
Gathered here today to worship God and to witness the marriage of Daniel Fincher and Brandy Heffenstahl. Let your light so shine before people that they may see your good works and give glory to God who is in heaven. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come today thanking you for what you have done this hour and this day. We ask you now to bless this ceremony. Let it not be just a ceremony for men, but let it be a ceremony that is done in heaven. We ask you and invite you to be a part of this, that you might be glorified, that your name will be high and lifted up this day. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Amen and amen. You may be seated. Friends and family, we've gathered together in the sight of God to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony. It is an honorable estate instituted of God, signifying unto us the mystical union that is between Christ and his church, the holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with his presence and first miracle in Cana of Galilee. It is commended in the scriptures to be honorable among all, and therefore is not to be entered into unadvisingly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, soberly, and in the fear of God. And to this holy estate, these two persons present themselves and now come to be joined. I ask, who will give this woman to be married to this man? As we have a declaration of intent, Daniel, I ask you, will you take Brandy to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keeping yourself only unto her so long as you both shall live? I do. For the witness. Brandy, I ask you, will you take Daniel to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in holy matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keeping yourself only unto him as long as you both shall live? The scriptures say, as the elect of God, holy and beloved, put on tender mercies, kindness, humility, meekness, long-suffering, bearing with one another and forgiving one another. If anyone has a complaint against another, even as Christ forgave you, you also must do. But above all these, put on love, which is the bond of perfection. And let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to which you also are called into one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another, in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. As we take the vows, I'm going to ask you to look at each other and take each other's hand. Daniel, would you repeat after me? I, Daniel. Take thee, Brandy. To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
This day forward.
This day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or poor.
For richer or poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death does us part.
Till death does us part.
According to God's holy word.
According to God's holy word.
Brandy, will you repeat after me? I, Brandy, take you, Daniel. Be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death does us part, according to God's holy word. As we enter into the ring ceremony, the ring is a token of this covenant that you have now shared. You will now give and receive the marriage rings, the unbroken circle, the emblem of eternity and of gold, the emblem that shows an everlasting love that does not tarnish, that will endure forever. Let me ask you at this time, can I have the rings? Heavenly Father, I come at this time thanking you once again for the opportunity, Lord, to marry these two, to signify their love. I thank you for them, that they have come forth to show each other the love that they have for one another, but Lord, to ultimately thank you for loving them, for placing in them love for one another. Lord, the scriptures say that love comes from you, and as a symbol of their love, Lord, I pray over these rings, that it reminds them of who has joined them together. Lord, it is not man but you. So Lord, we ask to bless these rings in Jesus' name. And repeat after me. With this ring,
I thee wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Those who God has joined together, let no one put asunder. For as much as Daniel and Brandy have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God, this congregation, and in doing so have given their pledge, their vows to one another, and have declared the same by giving and receiving of a ring, I pronounce them man and wife together in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Heavenly Father, I thank you once again for joining them, for allowing us to be a part and witness the union that you have done right here this very hour. We pray blessings upon them. We ask that your Spirit continue with them. And Lord, we pray that their marriage gives you praise and glory for long as they both shall live. Daniel, you may kiss your bride. Present to you Mr. and Mrs. Daniel Fisher.
My heart was wrapped up.